He found nothing, although the Joker turned up on top considerably less than once every 53 decks. He could not account for this, and so he kept pushing, figuring that once the sample was high enough, it would even out. But it didn't, and in fact, it became rarer still, bottoming out, it seemed, at 108 decks. Then it sank further still. This infuriated his sense of expectation and began to persuade him that perhaps there was a reality beyond measurement, a reality so complex that intuition was the only possible door to its perception. He wandered through this jungle of thought, the underbrush gradually thinning and the trees becoming more scattered, and he grew into an expert card slinger. He made them hover in midair, spinning for impossible seconds before dropping. He skimmed the surface of three walls with a single card. He landed them neatly on the seat of the toilet, never losing a single card to the basin. 5 months into his sentence, he was working on perfecting his boomerang toss when the forest of his mind gave way to a sun-kissed clearing, and he attained a clarity of thought that those who have known will attest can never be known for more than a few hours before the world caves in once more on the spirit. Lost in such trance, he lifted the next card, the ninth, as it turned out, and sent it sailing over four surfaces in his cell before it turned a somersault and landed solidly on its edge, standing up, the Joker facing him, laughing and dancing on the back of a bee. 12. Diablo could have spent the rest of his life trying to duplicate that trick. He certainly spent the remainder of his 9-month sentence trying to repeat it. He failed in this endeavor, but he did not fail to grasp that intuition realizes what reason cannot, that perception without expectation can, if permitted to flow, lead one unerringly through life. He felt certain in this conviction and resolved to test it with the chips of his own fate.